everybody. This video that I'm going to be doing, because it's full moon and it's 11th month, 11th day, 11th year, I'm actually making some candles today. And I got a white piece of paper and I've got some things on the paper. There's vibration, there's love, there's passion. Drew a picture of a flower. Drew a picture of a spiral, joy, self-love, physical love, forgiveness, and leaven, leaven, leaven. And what I have done is I got a friend of mine that gave me a bunch of roses, small little rose buds. And I got these a couple of days ago. I don't know why I got them, but now I do. So I've actually broken some of these up. And I've got them inside my thingy here. Now, what we're going to be doing is you're going to, because you want to bring positive energy to you, you're going to roll in a clockwise direction. So I'm actually going to mash up . Looks like we're doing pretty good so far. Yep. All right. We'll do this just a couple more times. So they're kind of good and powdery, almost powdery. And now I'm going to take these. And I'm going to sprinkle them onto the paper. I'm actually making candles. This is kind of a soft mauve-y pink colored candle. And so I've got a full thing of wax here and I'm keeping an eye on the temperature so it doesn't go into flash point. And just dunking it in. I've got some really nice music going too. Give it one more layer. Okay. And we're going to roll the candle towards us because we want the energy to come towards us. Just until you get fairly nice, decent coating on it. Okay. Then I'm going to take it back over to the stove. Just a quick dunk. Now, if you can, try to get at least 3 or 4 good layers on your candle before you go urban again. Okay. Now we'll come back over to the herbs. And again, you're going to want to roll it towards you. Now, while I'm actually rolling, I'm actually thinking of other positive things that I could have come to me besides what's on the paper. So in a sense, you're actually impregnating the candle with the energy of the words and the actual energy of the rose petals. Okay. Now we'll go back over. Hey, puppy. So, it's quit dripping, and now we'll go back over to the herbs. So, I will continue to do this, and I will show you what it looks like here in just a moment. Okay, I wanted to show everybody what my candle looked like. I'm actually finished with my candle, and it's actually hardened up quite a bit. Hopefully, you'll be able to see this. What I've actually done is, if I can pull it up to the light here, I've actually gone in and put in witch's alphabet, witch's Theban, and gone in and inscribed the word love into the candle. Hopefully, I'm going to see if I can't get a really, really close-up of that. So there's the letters right there, and in the bottom I actually put a heart underneath it. So because we are coming out of a full moon and fixing to go back into a waning moon aspect, I won't be burning this until probably next full moon, which is next month. So hopefully you've enjoyed watching me make this candle, and it's really, really fun. It's really relaxing. If you haven't never really done any hand dip candles before, you have to try it. That's all I have to say is you have to try it. It's really fun. Get your children involved. It's so long as that you're really careful with the fire. Make sure that you have a thermometer in your boiling water so that way you can keep an eye on the temperature. The flash point is somewhere around 300, I think. So I don't normally let it go above 200 degrees. And thank you for watching. If anybody has any comments or questions, I would love to answer. Thanks for watching, and take care. Blessed be. Love and peace. Bye.